Alright, we are going to be assembling our Space Saver Queen bed, which is our entry-level bed. It's built a little bit narrower with a single side rail to hold your mattress and box spring. I'm going to be starting with two 56-inch pieces drilled with 5 holes in each one. On one end of these logs, there's going to be a red marker mark. The other end will not have that. We want to make sure that these are, they have the red marker on the same end. We don't want to have them turn from one end to the other. Then we're going to be gluing in our 18-inch spindles. As always, we're using original Gorilla Glue. We have a white rubber mallet. If you do not have a white one, I'd recommend putting an old rag or a sock over the head of the mallet so that you don't leave black marks on the log.
As you can see, I have put glue on both sides of the hole.
And insert them into the second cross piece here. I want to make sure you have a flat workspace. If you don't have a table like this, the floor works great. Usually a big enough area. We're going to go ahead and glue on our corner posts now. These are going to be a 47-inch piece. Your headboard is going to have 3.5-inch holes. And when rotated 90 degrees, it'll have 1 2-inch hole where your side rail is bolted. In addition to our two cross pieces that are drilled, we have a third 56-inch piece that is not drilled. This goes into the third and lowest hole. It's just a support piece. Align all of the cross pieces. Now that that's completed, we're going to screw on a foot, which will hold it in the upright position while we apply our spray-down lacquer. So this is a completed headboard for our Space Saver Queen bed. Set this to the side and we'll do our footboard. We're going to be using two more 56-inch pieces with 5 holes. We're going to be using a non-drilled 18-inch spindle. Our corner posts for the footboard are 28 inches. They're going to have 2.5-inch holes, and when rotated 90 degrees, 1 2-inch hole where the side rail bolts in. insert our spindles. And then we will glue on our corner pole. I'm just turning the spindles and rotating them. I have the same amount showing on the top and bottom side. There you have a completed footboard for our Space Saver queen size bed.